There are many ESP32 products with a display on the market. I think this is because more and more projects are using displays recently. So I'd like to compare several products currently on the market. Among the display modules we can use in the ESP32, most of the 3.5-inch display modules use the ILI9488 and ST7796 graphic controller. Let's compare some products that use this graphic controller together. There are the things I prepared today. This is LilyPi from LilyGo, which I have been working on the most projects so far. It's a very solid product and thick because of the two layers of the USB interface. I recommend it if you need lots of external interfaces. It has a 3.5-inch capacitive touchscreen with ST7796. The next one is WT32-SC01 from Wireless Tag. This is a popular product recently. It has a very simple design including the display. It really looks good. There are female headers on the back that allow easy access to the GPIO. It has a 3.5-inch capacitive touchscreen with ST7796. The next one is ESP32-S2 with 3.5-inch display from MakerFabs. Unlike other devices, this device adopts ESP32-S2. Also, it's connecting the display in a 16-bit parallel instead of full-wire SPI interface. Probably this is expected to be the fastest one to draw something to the display. Because it's equipped with ESP32-S2, it's also advantage to be able to use native USB. It has a 3.5-inch capacitive touchscreen with ILI9488. The last one is just ESP32 with ILI9488. Before many products with a display are available on the market, I usually directly purchase the ESP32 and display module separately and then connect the two. If you like my channel, you know what project I have been working on so far. This is just connected Lolin32+ and ILI9488 display. It has a 3.5-inch resistive touchscreen with ILI9488. From Wrapped, LilyPi, WT32-SC01, MakerFabs device, and Lolin32+. All are using the Rovian GFX graphics library. As expected, the 16-bit parallel connection was able to finish the specified task the fastest. It didn't even take a second. It's crazy. Since each device has a different connection method, I had to set the parameters that they can draw as quickly as possible for each device. WT32-SC01 is connected by HSPI and LilyPi is by VSPI. Although it's the same ST7796 graphic IC, the SPI write speed operates differently. On the other hand, the ILI9488 connected to the Lolin32+ was the slowest. This is because DMA is not available and it writes SPI at 40 MHz. As you can see from the results above, the DMA mode is critical to draw the display quickly. Also, ESP32 DMA mode is for SPI display only. DMA mode is not available on 8-bit or 16-bit parallel connections. And also, ILI9488 doesn't allow the DMA either. This is why the ILI9488 connected by 4-wire SPI is the slowest. What we'll test this time is a Boeing board on one of the examples of TFT SPI. This example redraws a wallpaper and board according to the movement of the board. This is a kind of the heavy work. The previous test was a short test, but since this is an infinite test, we will be able to test the real capabilities of each display. This is a more interesting test. ILI9488 connected in a 16-bit parallel should be the fastest, but the combination of ST7796 and DMA turned on is refreshing the screen the fastest. We can use a 16 GPIO to send the whole 16-bit pixel at once without any bit shifting. But in order to send a 16-bit word, it takes a minimum of 3 writes to the GPIO port, which on the ESP32 is very slow. The ESP32 GPIO port write speed is relatively slow at 50 nanoseconds. This is about panel quality. All set to the maximum brightness and screenshots were taken as identically as possible. Of all the devices I tested, the WT32-SC01 was the best. In general, it's difficult to see the LCD screens outdoors under the sunlight, but the WT32-SC01's panel looks the best of these. It also had a few reflections which made it easier to read the content. If you choose a 3.5-inch display on the ESP32, I think the product that supports 80 MHz and DMA on the ST7796 is the best. I prefer larger displays whenever they are available, but the larger the display of the SPI interface or a 16-bit parallel interface is available on ESP32, the more expensive it is. So I think the 3.5-inch display is the most appropriate for my project. Of course, if I get a chance, I'd like to try the over 7-inch displays. I compared the 4 products in this video. The most important thing is to organize the system that fits the project budget. I hope this helps you choose a display for your project. When a new product is released on the market, I will compare it again. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.